Motec Sir here, and are you looking to update your Retroid Pocket 2 to the latest 8.1 version? Well, stay tuned because I've got you covered. So, I did say I wasn't going to do another video until the new year, but Retroid actually dropped this new update over the holiday season. So, I know a lot of you are new to the community or have just got one of the devices for Christmas and you want to update it to the latest installation. So, in this guide, I'm going to show you how to do it. So the first two things we need is to download these two folders. We need the RP2 8.1 version with guide, and we need the stock apps 8.1 version 2 internal with guide. So grab these from the link down below, and if you're going to do it via the SD card and not the actual internal memory, then download that one also. So the first thing we are going to do is actually back up our key. So this is pretty simple and straightforward, but you need to do this for the Retroid OS system to work. So the first thing we do is we go into the RP2 8.1 version with guide folder. Then we click onto the RP2 key backup tool. We launch the ABD driver installation and we make sure that it's installed. So once this is installed, you should see a little notification at the bottom saying already installed. That's good to go. And then the next thing we need to do is actually click on the RP2 key backup bat file. This will work its magic and this will back up the bat file. Now, we're going to leave that there for now. We will be coming back to this later, but that's all you need to do for now. So the next thing we're going to do is actually flash the device so we can get the latest firmware on it, which is 8.1 version 2. So we need to go back into the folder that we were just in, and we need to go onto SB Flash. Now what we need to do here, we need to load the flash tool. So click on that, let it load up. Now you're going to see mine. Mine looks a lot different to yours just because I've already flashed it a few times, so the files are already there. So what we're going to do first is we're going to go on download agent. We're going to click choose. And what we're going to do is we're going to click onto MTK all in one. Click on that. And that will be good to go. Now the scatter file is going to be in a different place to what you've already chosen. It's actually going to be in the Android 8.1 version 2. So all you need to do is back out of the folder, find Android 8.1 version 2, click on the scatter file, and you're good to go. Now one important thing to remember once you've done this is you need to unplug the USB from the Retroid Pocket 2. Power down the device, because if you do not do that, guys, this will not install the update. So this is really important. Unplug the USB cable, power down the device, and then just leave it sitting there. The next thing we need to do is go onto the drop-down menu. We click on Format All and Download. Once we click that, we actually click Download on the software. So you won't see anything happening. Now the magic works when you plug back in the USB. So plug the USB back into your Retroid Pocket 2, and then you will see a progression bar at the bottom and it will start to load. Now with the magic of editing, we have speeded this up because it can take around, I'd say 3 to 5, up to 10 minutes. Just be patient, it will do its magic and it will work. Once this is all installed, you will see a green tick on the screen. Click the software off, unplug the USB, and reboot the Retroid Pocket 2. Now, if you see this triangle on your Retroid OS when it boots up, do not worry. The only reason why I've got this on is because I haven't got the ROMs installed. You guys may have not got the ROMs installed yet. I just don't like the Retroid OS system, so I don't really use it, so I deleted all the ROMs from it. So what you need to do now, guys, is you need to boot into the Android side of things. So you're going to press home. And then what you're going to do after this is you're going to go down to the bottom and press switch systems. Let it build in, let it do its thing. It will take a while and then we'll be able to get straight onto the Android system. So once you build it on, it's going to install a couple of things. So just be patient and we will get the device up and running. Once you boot into the Android side of things, it will take a while to boot in. Just be patient, guys, and it will boot in. Now, what we're going to do now is we're going to actually install the key that we backed up earlier. So we're going to go and do the same thing. We're going to go back into the Retroid Pocket 2 8.1 version 1 with guide folder. Go on to the RP2 key backup tools and then load the ABD driver installer. You can press install again. It's going to be installed anyway. Make sure your Retroid Pocket 2 is connected via USB or this will not work. And then once you've connected it all up, click Retroid Pocket 2 key restore bat and it will restore the file. It will work its magic, do a couple of things, and then it will reboot your Retroid Pocket 2. So now we come to the good stuff. Now we come to getting all the internal apps installed on the device. So what we want to do first is we want to connect the device to our PC. Make sure we've got internal transfer files on the Retroid Pocket 2. You can do that by going to the top, dragging the bar down and clicking on it that way, choosing the option which one you want to use. By default, it's on charge. Once we've done that, we will open it up. Now mine's called Retroid Pocket 2, yours may be called something different, but that doesn't matter at all. So what we need to do is we need to click on this and go into the internal storage. Once the internal storage is up, we go onto the stock apps, we go into that folder, and the next thing we do is we drag all of these folders into the internal Retroid Pocket 2 storage. Now this is going to take some time. It's not going to take a year, but it is going to take some time. For some reason, it just doesn't like to transfer, and it tells you all gobbledygook. It'll tell you it's going to take 5 years and 3 minutes and 6 years and 2 days and 1 day. Just let it do its magic. It will take around 20 to 30 minutes, guys. I promise you that's all it's going to take. So once this is all done, guys, you can actually unplug the USB. Now the main thing that we need to do now is install the prescript. So the next thing we need to do is we need to install the prescript once the files have been transferred over. You can unplug the USB now. So how we're going to do it is we scroll down to toolbox, then we go on to execute prescript. I've already got this highlighted, and then we go onto the three dots at the top, show internal storage, and we click down to the internal storage, as you can see here, and then the prescript file will be at the bottom. Click on it, press open, and it will run. It will install all the files that you've just uploaded onto the device. Now again, this does take a bit of time, so do not worry at all. Once this is done, you can actually delete the pre-installed file that's on the internal memory. If you want to do so, you can. It's not a problem at all. If you don't, then that's totally fine as well. But you are able to delete it if you want to. So the folders you can delete, just to make you aware again, is the pre-install folder and the internal pre-install file. But as you can see here, guys, all the apps are on the device and good to go. So that's been a really quick video on how to install the software, guys. Hopefully this has helped you out and got the device up and running to the latest software if you do want to run it. Please be aware, follow this guide down to a T. If for any reason you divert from this guide, you can potentially brick the device. Follow this to a T and you won't have any problems at all. If you've got any problems at all, guys, check out the Discord. We are always in there, happy to help. Or just drop me a comment down below and let me know what's going on so I can help you out. We've got a couple more videos up as well on the screen now, guys. So if you're new to the Retroid Pocket 2 community, and you got one of these for Christmas, check out the video how to install ROMs onto your device and a couple of other ones as well, how to run Doom and Quake and Half-Life on the device as well. But until next year, stay safe and I'll see you all soon.